So this is a 60 degree angle here. I'm gonna ask Patrick, can you sit your hip like right up against? Yeah, fantastic, perfect. And then rest your head all the way back there. Now it's important that the patient sits right up the back, because if they're already sitting in a posterior pelvic tilt, like a high degree of one, and then you move this back, they're already gonna be creating a high degree of spinal flexion, which it's not the spinal flexion that's the issue, it's that we've already stopped the test. So he's already out of position. So always make sure the patient's right hard up against there. The second thing here we want to do is we want to measure an angle of 90 degrees across his torso. So if you go torso here, leg forward, so feet forward, 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 keep going, keep going, keep going. Yep, fantastic, that's more than fine. So we want a 90 degree angle here. And importantly, we also want, excellent, no, it's okay, you can keep your feet there. Excellent. You also want the feet, the knee and the hip in one straight line. So Patrick, I'm gonna get your feet a little bit closer together. Fantastic, matey, awesome. So we're gonna strap him down. Obviously you're getting feedback from the patient the whole time on, you know, are you still getting blood flow to your feet? That's critical. And you don't wanna put too much pressure. You'd be surprised, you don't need that much pressure on the feet in order to hold him there. You okay like that?
Yeah, it's perfect.
It's not too hard? Excellent. Obviously, we don't want him to move, so we do want it tight enough for that, but that looks pretty good. Knee position, just track out a fraction. Perfect, matey. And feet just nice and flat down there. Awesome. So I'm also instructing Patrick to hold his hands across his shoulders. If you get somebody really big, some of the bodybuilders, etc., they might be fingertip across the shoulder. That's fine. As long as there's some point of the hand in contact with the shoulders, he's good to go. And notice I keep cueing him like head back, head back. So that's really important too. Now, last thing, often you'll see patients when you move this back, whatever you've got them secured behind them, they will flare the elbows out. Don't like cue them not to do that, because immediately they'll flex forward and they'll change the test position, and it can also enhance the test time. Okay, excellent. So that's a quick cheat, or quick tip, I should say. Now, three reasons you're going to come down, right? Number one, you can't hold it any longer, which is what I want you to aim for, okay? I'm not going to cue you on what your time is ongoingly. You're just going to hold. Excellent. Number two, you get pain. Again, we go through that process of where, what's your rating? Is it reproducing your back pain or not, okay? And then number three, if you lower down and contact the wedge, this wedge is going to be moved back, and I've pre-measured here. So this is this 10 centimeter point. So I'm gonna move this back. So the back of this is directly in line with the back of the table. My table is just permanently marked. If he contacts that in any way, then we stop the test, okay? You ready?
Ready to go.
Excellent. Does someone have a timer? We're not gonna hold him for too long, just for the record. Excellent. We'll do a minute and we'll see how you go. Okay, so Patrick, on three, I'm gonna move this back, ready? One, two, three. Beautiful. So that's lining up with the back of the table. He's securely holding this position. Now, what are you feeling?
Abdominals and hip flexors.
Abs and hip flexors. Okay, great. And if 100% is a full ratio, what do we experience? Is it like a 50-50 or?
Probably 60 or 70% abs.
Yep.
And then 30, 40.
Okay, you've totally been doing planks and stuff. That's great. That's excellent. That's really good. It's a really good ratio, right? Obviously, we are testing the hip flexors in this position, but we don't want to see like 90, 95% hip flexor and very little abdominal. You can also see or palpate, he's really engaged. He's not trying to, he just is, which is great. Okay. What's our time at?
10 seconds.
To a minute. Okay, fantastic. No pain. All right, fantastic. And he hasn't contacted the entire time, so you've still got a clean bill there. All right, beautiful. Come back. Thank you, everyone, for coming. That's Patrick's night. Done and dusted. Good job, matey. Okay, so we would note down, obviously we're cutting it short for filming and otherwise purposes, but we would note down his test time. We would note down that 70% he's reporting abdominal sort of contribution to the test. That's what he's experiencing, and 30% hip flexor, okay? Now, bringing in my own practical experience here, often you'll hear about a 90-95% and maybe a little bit of abdominal, okay? And so, and their test time might actually be quite good and it might compare really well to normative data. But if you're hearing the motor response is just, there's virtually no app. If you give them a very isolated abdominal exercise within that context, they're going to be shaking immediately, and I'm actually going to cover that exercise at the very end of the session as well, okay? So often you'll hear that imbalance, and it's important to note it so that you know, hang on, I think he's great hip flexor-wise, but maybe not so much abdominal, okay?